All right, now I'm live. All right, so let's take a look at this. Today I want to talk about, what is it, 322? Graphing parabolas. In vertex form. This is the easy stuff. This is easier than what we did yesterday. We already kind of know how to do today's lesson because we've talked about it before and other things. So I think today's going to be pretty nice. So here we go. We need this. Y equals A X minus H squared plus K. All right, write that down, please. That's our formula. That's our formula for any vertex in vertex form, any parabola in vertex form. A couple of things we know. The square tells us it's a parabola. We see x squared, we know it's a parabola, okay? We automatically know, because of the x squared, it's going to have that shape, right? We know that. If it's an x squared, it's going to have that shape. Whether it's a smiley face or a frowny face, it's going to have that shape because it's an x squared. Okay? Now, we also know it's going to have a line of symmetry going straight down the middle of it, right? So it's going to have a line of symmetry somewhere. Let me put my line of symmetry in there. So my line of symmetry goes right through the middle of it. Everybody agree with that? Our line of symmetry is this value. It's just x equals h. So whatever number's here, it's always going to be the line of symmetry. Of course, it's the opposite, right? We know it's the opposite. And that's why we have the subtract there. Okay, that's the line of symmetry. Easy. If I say what's the line of symmetry, you don't have to do any negative b over 2a. You just say the line of symmetry is that number. That's why I like vertex form. We also know the vertex being right there is the value h, k. So whatever numbers you have here, h, k is the vertex. I like vertex form. It makes life easy for me, okay?
Is it just called vertex form because
it has the vertex right in it? Yes, totally right, Scott. Yeah. So what we saw yesterday was this. We saw standard form yesterday.
And that you have to find by itself.
Yeah. Standard form was the y equals ax squared plus bx plus c. And they're both parabolas, but just a different form, that's all. And then we know for this one, you'd have to use the negative b over 2a for standard form. But for vertex, it's sweet. I mean, there's my answer, right? There's no work to be done. It's easy, okay? Now, the y-intercept is easy on standard form, okay? Check this out. The y-intercept is this number if it's in standard form, whatever this number is. But the y-intercept takes a little bit more work. So to find the y-intercept, we just let x equals 0 and simplify. And then we'll get the y-intercept. To get the x-intercepts, because it does have x-intercepts, right? We're going to let y equals 0 and solve. Okay, and I'm going to talk more about that today, okay? How am I doing? So let's do an example, and I'll show you how all this works, okay? Slide it up, okay? I take a look at example one. It says just find the line of symmetry and the vertex. That's all I have to do. So this one's super easy, okay? We don't have to do a lot. So I know the line of symmetry. Line of symmetry. Well, it's just going to be the value of h. The line of symmetry is x equals the opposite of h, right? Is the opposite of h. Well, h is 4. H is 4. It's always the opposite inside, right? Always the opposite. Always the opposite of the inside. Want me to do a little dance for you? No. Pretty much. No thanks. So I know my line of symmetry, and this one's just simply going to be an x equals negative 4. That's it. Easy, right? There's no negative b over 2a. It's just that number, opposite number, okay? And the vertex then has to be these two numbers. Has to be these two numbers. So it's a negative 4, always the opposite, positive 5. We don't have to graph this one. All we needed is just these two things. I needed the line of symmetry, easy. I got that from my equation, and my vertex, I got that from the equation. So it's always the opposite inside, okay? And we're going to understand why that is. Okay, now, example 2. Again, we don't have to graph example 2. We just have to answer some questions, okay? So compare. Compare. We want to use words, okay? So first of all, we're going to compare it to our parent function. You don't have to graph this, but I'm going to because I want you to see it. You do not have to graph 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. But I want you to see it, okay? So if I compare these, it's always nice to get a picture. It helps me a bunch, okay? So first of all, let me put down my parent function. Parent function, 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 3, 9, 3, 9, and there, there, and there, okay? There's my parent function. That's simply just y equals x squared. We've done that one before, okay? Again, we've done this bunches of times, right, Calvin?
How'd you guys get so close together, huh? So here's my parent function, right? Everything's x squared, right? X squared, right? And so I do the t table in my head because we're smart, right? So what's 0 times 0? Over 1, what's 1 times 1? Over 2, 2 times 2 is
4.
3 times 3 is? And then flip it. Thumbs up. So parent function, super easy, right? Now, what's going to happen to this one? Between, so I'm going to move the parent function. So give me words. I'm going to move the parent function. Where's the vertex?
Where's my vertex? Positive 3, positive 1. Good. Totally agree. And where's my line of symmetry? X is equal to 3. Good. Okay, write that down. I know the vertex has to be the opposite. The line of symmetry has to go through. So if I'm at 3, 1, all we're going to do is take our vertex and move it to here. I'll say it again. Here's my vertex of my parent function. I'm just going to move it, move it to 3, 1. Okay, everybody okay with that? Now there's one more thing. What's the 1 half going to do? What's the 1 half going to do? What's the 1 half going to do?
What's the 1 half? What's this 1 half mean? Half as tall, right? Does that make sense? Half as tall. So we did 1, 1, 2, 4, 3, 9. But now I'm going to go from here. 1, 1 half. Half as tall. 2, 2, and 3. Well, half a 9 is 4 and a half. So I'm just going to put there. Okay, so it's just half as tall, right? So
instead of going 1, 1, I'll go 1, 1 half. Instead of going 2, 4, I'm going to go 2, and only half of 4 is 2, and then 3. Instead of going up to 9, I'll go 4 and a half. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, about 4 and a half. About there. It doesn't have to be perfect, but I want to get the general shape of it, okay? Now, it didn't ask me to graph it, it just asked me to compare, okay? So compare, let's use those words. I know the vertex, so we did a translation. Here's the words, translation. We did translation, we went right, 3, up, 1. Translation means to move, okay, you ready with that? Translation means right, 3, up, 1, and then we made it a vertical shrink of 1 half. So it wants me to compare. So I need to use some words. And I did. I used my words. Here's my words. The translation moved it over to the right, 3, up 1, because my vertex, and then I made it half as tall. How am I doing? We're doing all right? Okay, you ready to turn the page? So, now this one I'm going to have to graph. So I have to get some graph paper out, see what I can do with my graph paper. Let's get the easy stuff. So I'm looking at graphing example 3. When I say the easy stuff, what is the easiest thing to find on this equation? What's the easiest thing to find in this equation? The vertex. Totally agree. The vertex. Tell me, what is the vertex? I agree. What is the vertex?
-1, -4.
Awesome. So that's the easy part. So I'm going to go to my graph. I'm going to put that down. I'm going to totally agree, right? Let's get the easy stuff down. So I'm going to go to my -1, -4, right? I can do this. So we're at -1, -4. 1, 2, 3, 4. There's my vertex. Okay, good. I also have a line of symmetry, don't I? So what's my line of symmetry? I've got a line of symmetry. What's that? What's my line of symmetry? Line of symmetry. It's negative one, right? It's got to go right through there. It's -1. So it's x equals -1, right? Because it's got to go through the vertex, right? So I'm going to put that in. Okay, all right. Now I need more points. So first of all, let's find the y-intercept. So my notes, I'm going to write this down. Y-intercept. Write this down. So if I'm going to find the y-intercept, my notes say let x equal 0, okay? So my notes say, let x equal 0. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. I'm going to put 0 in for x. So I'm going to go y equals 0 plus 1 squared minus 4, right? And I'm going to simplify that, right? So to find the y-intercept, I just let x equal 0. So I'm going to go y equals 1 squared minus 4. Which is really 1 minus 4, y is equal to -3, okay? All right, so I've got a y-intercept, and that's at the point 0, -3. Okay, I can put that on my graph too, can't I? So go back to my graph. I've got a point then at 0, -3, which gives me a second point, or a third point, right? Yep. Here's my y-intercept. I also have a point right there, but agree? Right there, because it's symmetrical, so I'm going to put a point there. Okay, now, I want the x-intercepts. Am I going too fast? Okay. So I want the x-intercepts. So let's see my graph. My notes say let y equal 0 and solve. All right, so I'm going to go and to find my x-intercepts, I'm going to say 0 equals x plus 1 squared minus 4, okay? And I'm going to go slowly through this with you, okay? We're going to solve for x, all right? Well, let's see. This be the same thing as x plus 1 times x plus 1 minus 4, right? Do you agree with that? I wrote this twice, which would be the same thing as an x squared plus a 1x plus another 1x minus 4. Do you guys agree with that? I just did my that times that, that times that, that times that, that times that. Am I going too fast? So I needed to solve. What I'm thinking is I'm going to have to factor, but I'll get there. All right, I'm going to get to factoring. Oh, I forgot a plus 1. Plus 1, that's important. 1 times 1, Mr. Davies, is 1. So then I'd have a 0 equals an x squared plus a 2x minus 3. Ah, this looks really familiar. I think we've been doing this for the last month.
factor many equations, right? We've been doing this for a month.
Factor many equations? How about factor? Hey, we've been learning this stuff for a reason. We've been learning factoring for a reason. What do you know? X and X, right? Plus 3 minus 1, right? And then my mini equation should give me x equals negative 3 and x equals positive 1, right? Hey, we've been learning how to factor for a reason. They give us the x-intercepts. I know, I've been hiding that from you, huh? Kind of, sort of, right? Okay, then I'll have a x-intercept at 1 and at negative 3. Well, I can graph my parabola now. Pretty much, it's all right there, isn't it? How's that? Okay, ready for the last one? Last example, I'll wait for you. Okay, example 4. It says rewrite in standard form, then graph the parabola. Before I do anything, let's take the easy stuff, okay? Let's take the easy stuff. Before I even graph this, I already know the vertex. What's the vertex? Before I do anything, don't mess it up. What's the vertex right off the bat? Yeah, negative 1, negative 5. I know my line of symmetry. Is at x equals negative 1. You guys okay with that? So before we mess it all up and change it, let's take the easy step, okay? So we're going to find that both forms, we did yesterday and what we did today, both forms have advantages, some. Okay, so I'm going to have to multiply this out. I can do that. Okay, y equals 2. I'm going to go x plus 1. X plus 1, right? Minus 5, okay? And I wrote it twice because the squared, right? I wrote it twice because of the squared. You okay with that? Then I'm going to go that times that, x squared. X times 1, 1x. 1 times x, another 1x. And 1 times 1 is 1, minus 5. Okay, now let's catch up. So all I'm doing is I want to put it in standard form. So I'm going to multiply it all out, okay? Now, I'm going to have 2x squared and 1x and 1x makes a 2x, so plus a 2x plus 1 minus 5. Am I going too fast or am I okay? I'm trying to go slowly. So all I've done is I wrote this twice. I foiled it. I added the two middle terms. Now the next thing I'm going to do is multiply through my 2. I'm going to distribute 2 times x squared, 2 times 2, and 2 times 1. So I'm going to distribute the 2. So y equals a 2x squared plus 4x plus 2 minus 5. And I just about have it done. I do. Y equals a 2x squared plus 4x minus 3. Now I'm going to graph it. Okay? I know some easy stuff. I know the vertex. I also know the y-intercept. So the cool part about standard form, the only good part about standard form, the only good part is this number right here. That's my y-intercept. So in standard form, your y-intercept is just staring at you. That is your y-intercept. So my y-intercept is at 0, negative 3. And graphing this can be easy. I only need 3 points, which I will have 3 points in a moment. So graph this. Let's put down what we know. And then the rest is easy. All right, I'm going to put down, right, and I'm going to go there, there, and I'm going to go ahead and put down, first my vertex, is it negative 1, negative 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay, there's my vertex, right? My line of symmetry goes right down the middle of it, there's my line of symmetry. So line of symmetry is at x equals negative 1. I've got a point at 0, negative 3, right? And then I have a third point. I have a third point right there. Right? Right there is my third point. And I can draw them in and be done. How's that? So, in conclusion, because it's worth saying, okay, in conclusion, we have two ways to do a parabola, two ways. One, vertex form. Sweet, we got the vertex right away, right? The other is standard form, which gives us the y-intercept. They both have their advantages. I like vertex forms the best because I like to get the vertex from it, but they both work. Okay, so here's our homework for today. We're going to go to page 92 and 93. We'll take a little break, but I want to write this down before we lose our eighth graders. Page 92 and 93. We're going to do 5 through 12. All, you don't have to graph them all. The first part is only just saying what's the vertex, what's the line of symmetry, okay? And then you'll have to graph some of these. So let me go stop recording. Stop.